其实他讲的如来藏是跟缘起不可分隔出来的，不能说没有缘起就能够成立如来藏，因为整他的实景他的有要跟着缘起来升起。
So this relates us to the understanding that, you know, the doctrine of the Buddha nature is inseparable, you know, with the doctrine of dependent arising. Otherwise, you know, you can easily claim that things arise out of random, you know. Well, the way that, you know, Master Tam interprets this highest principle of dependent arising gives us an insight into, you know, the nature of our existence. But also, you know, it's not in any way different from our more, you know, mundane, more usual kind of understanding of cause and effect. So it elevates the understanding to another level.
正因为如来藏是这样讲的，所以因此我们那个实景，在实景世界是十分的真实的。不能说因为它空它就不真实，等于我们说它空等于刚才讲它是一千，因为它给零定位了，定成一千了，只要我们把它叫做空。一千跟一，一百跟十跟一都是靠后边的定位，其实都是一显现出来，都是一个一字，可是为什么这个是一千，这个是一呢？就是靠空，空胜，定为胜，定它出来。
So because of this understanding that our world, our realm of consciousness, arises out of this adaptability to different constraints, we have to say that the world that we experience right now is very, very real, you know. Just because we call it empty doesn't mean that it is unreal in any way. It's just like the numbers that you are seeing. You know, what actually appears is just the number one, you know, this number one, you know. But in order to distinguish them into 1,110 or one, we need those, you know, positioning of the zeros to make it meaningful or understandable. So our world arising, you know, arise like this, you know, it's just like that. It doesn't mean that it is unreal.
所以我们说荧光屏的影像不真实，可是荧光屏的影像假如在影像世界里边就十分真实了，等于一跟一千那么真实。
So from the perspective of the viewer, you know, watching the television, of course we can say thatappears on the TV screen are not ultimately real, they are just images. But imagine yourself to be, you know, one of those images on the screen. You know, within this circumstance, you know, while you are one of these images, you know, things that are arising must be very real to you. You cannot dismiss that as simply unreal.
那么就是说缘起世界是真实的，所以因此这个缘起世界跟我们人生就有关系。
So the world of dependent arising from our perspective, human's perspective, is real, and because of this reality that we're talking about, you know, dependent arising has intricate, you know, in relation to ourlivelihoods,
to our own lives. 我们每一个人在这个世界上其实都要受教育，教育其实给我们是什么，就是给适应这个社会的能力。
So when we were raised in this worldOf course, we've all gone through different levels of education. But what education does good to us is to allow us to adapt to the society, to allow us to find a living, you know, to be able to live, you know, our lives.
甚至我们在这个世界上面，在什么地方生长，都要受他这个文化背景的限制。如果不适应他的文化背景，我们就不能在这里生活了。
So,
这就是相爱缘起了。
So wherever we were born, wherever we were raised, and wherever we are living, we are under the constraints of the cultural background of that society.
我想起1986年我到夏威夷过海关的时候，那个海关看我身上只有$2,000，他就说你怎么样在夏威夷生活？$2,000，我说我有 credit card。
So when Master Tam moved to Hawaii in the 1980s, he only carried with him about $2,000 and $2,000 US, and he was asked how he can actually
by the custom.
So he was asked how he can actually possibly survive, and he said, "Oh well, I have credit cards."
He said, "What?" I said, "I have a credit card." What? I no map. I only show him the card. He said, "Oh, charge card." 这就是说，假如我讲 credit card， 就不能在夏威夷生存了，因为到处都讲 charge card。
So if he said credit card, so it's a lingo joke. If he said credit card, then he can't survive. But if he said charge cards, then he can survive in Hawaii.
所以我就后来晓得，我要在夏威夷生存，我要另外学这个语言嘛。我吃早餐的时候，我要他要一些 jam， 他们怎么都弄不懂什么叫 jam。后来说半天了，他就说哦 ，the jello。
Can you guess what he was talking about? Jello. So in Hawaii, he discovered he has to learn a whole new set of lingos. So he went out for breakfast and he kept asking for jam, and no one understood what he was asking for until maybe after much negotiation, and they end up that, oh, you actually want jello? That's easy.
So, 如果你要咖啡，你要多一点奶，他们要说 coffee in milk。如果你要小一点奶，他就说 milk in coffee。
Well, I have to explain. So there's something to do with if you want more milk, then you have to ask coffee and milk. If you want less milk, it says milk and coffee.
所以通所有语言都要适应。
So even about languages and communication, you have to adapt to the constraints.
要不然你到吃早餐，到跟政府官员打交道都没法子。
Otherwise, you can't even get, you know, get meet your survival needs, get breakfast, or even deal with the customs.
啊，所以啊，那这是举一个简单的例。
That's a very simple example of constraint satisfaction.
相爱缘起当然给这个深得多了，可是如果我们怎么简单的理解，又可以说。也是相爱缘起的实验。
So, in actuality, the thinking behind mutual obstruction or constraint faction can be much more profound, but you can also understand through these simple examples, they are in some sense also adaptation for constraint satisfaction.
所以学佛家的如来藏思想，不但只可以学佛，在日常生活里边。都能够弄懂，我们能够弄懂思维的方法。思维的方法就是看事情有些什么障碍，要有什么障碍，我们要适应的，而且我们整个运作与障碍有什么关系。
So in fact, you to learn Buddhism, you don't only about learning about the behavior of Buddha, but also you can understand about mutual obstruction or constraint satisfaction to help you to think about sort of the different issue of life and can be very conventional and mundane.
例如现在整个世界的问题就是经济问题了。从这个经济问题如果弄得不好，可能会弄出战争出来。
So for example, to take a step up, you can think about the current situation, about the financial crisis. If you don't sort out your thinking or about adapting to the constraint satisfaction, you know, you can, it can escalate to something as serious as, you know, the Third World War.
我们看什么有什么主要因素是对这个货币有障碍的呢？
So, for example, you can think about the different types of constraints regarding to the, to our currency.
其实很简单，就是对货币的信心。
Very simply, it's about our confidence in our in the currency.
信心从哪里来呢？ 从实力来。
So confidence comes from is its credibility of the currency.
实力可以分两方面，一个是军事的力量，一个是生产力。
Credibility or it can be thought of in two different ways. One is in terms of military power, the other way is in terms of
所以有，所以生产力够了，军力够了，就有实力了，有实力有信心，它的货币就成强的货币。So
if you have productivity or if you have military power, then you arise, you have credibility, you have credibility, you arise confidence, you have confidence, then you have the currency.
所以整个货币的三个缘起就是怎么一回事。
To think about the mutual obstruction of the constraint satisfaction of the currency, it's really this whole host of constraints.
我们先看美元，美元起初它的生产力跟军事力量都不是怎么特殊的时候，他们就另外找一种力，就是金本位了。
So let's look at the U.S. currency. In the very beginning, when we are not emphasized too much on the productivity as well as the military power, so what creates this credibility of the U.S. currency is the gold. Using currency associated with the gold.
So, gold trust.
And that's why on the U.S. dollar, it printed in gold. In gold, we trust.
那时候是一块一盎司的黄金是35美元，是固定下来的。So
that time, for every ounce of gold bullion is can exchange for $35, and this is a fixed exchange rate.
那么这样发行的美元就有限制了。So
with this type of constraint. Then the printing of the money, there's a lot of limitation.
那怎么样打破这个限制，发行更多的美元呢？
So how can you break through this limitation and constraint, and in order to print more money?
那么就要打破这个金本位。
So you have to break the relationship between U.S. dollar and the gold bullion.
那么美元就变成 in gold. We trust.
And that's why now the U.S. dollar printed is in God we trust instead of in gold we trust.
那么如果是这样的话，只有靠这两个了。So
when you talk about in God we trust, then you need the productivity as well as the military power to support it.
那么生产力怎么样来算呢？
So how can you calculate this productivity?
以前我们算的是，你生产这个杯一块钱，你的生产力就是一块钱。So
in the past we are talking about GNP. So when you produce $1 of let's say the cup, worth $1, then your productivity is $1.
现在改 GDP 了。So
now it's changed to called GDP.
GDP 就是那个贸易的数字。 我这个杯卖给他，他再卖给他，他再卖给他，所以这一块钱的杯就变成4块钱。So
when you use GDP instead of GNP, then $1 of cup, when you sell to 10 people, then becomes $10. So $1 becomes $10 when you use GDP instead of GNP.